Good afternoon, Excellency, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. It is my great pleasure to be here, and I would like to thank the organizer for excellent arrangement and hospitality. Today, let me take the opportunity to talk about energy security to work for Cambodia. For some of you who do not know Cambodia, so I would like to introduce you. Cambodia is located. Cambodia located with the border near Thailand, Vietnam, and Laos. And we have two seasons, rainy season and dry season. And the GDP growth rate about 7%. And GDP per capita is $1,220. Excellency, ladies and gentlemen, energy is the lifeblood of the global economy. It plays significant input nearly all of the goods and services of our modern world as we know. Stable, reasonable price, energy supply, and security are central to maintain and improving the living standard of our people. At the same time, energy issues are not only limited to a country alone, but it also plays a role in the global challenge, such as a preservation of natural resources, the protection of environment, and the containment of climate change. Energy should be treated as a valuable asset and must be utilized consistently and essentially in order to be available for the development and well-being of the energy security in the country and in the region. I would like to inform you the most important aspect of the Royal Government of Cambodia. Economy policy is to further expand electricity supply, cooperate with lower tariffs, and diversify energy supply sources in order to reduce reliance on importation power and fossil fuel oil for power generation. We recognize that energy security forms a part of overall national energy policy that not only just promote energy sector, but also overall economic growth and development in Cambodia. In order to continue support and develop our energy security for Cambodia, I would like to take the opportunity to give a presentation on the power sector development plan of Cambodia. The content we have, eight content of the presentation is, now we talk about future of electricity organization. We have EDC, is a power authority, state-owned enterprise. And we have Ministry of Mine and Energy is the owner of EDC, and Ministry of Economic and Finance also the owner. We have regulator as name Electricity Authority of Cambodia that play role as tariff setting, licensing, and regulator. Energy policy is it to provide an adequate supply of energy, mainly with a reasonable price, and we need to develop our energy resource and encourage the efficient use of energy. Talking about power, Cambodia power strategy, that we have development of generation plan and development of transmission line and development of rural education. You know, talking about increasing our diversity of power supply, such as hydro, coal, power, importing electricity, biomass, and other renewable energy to meet electricity demand and reduce fuel oil or power generation. As you know that fuel oil for power generation is 100% import from neighboring country. In our country, on the upstream side, we are not yet an oil producing country. Most of petroleum resources are still in the exploitation stage for both onshore and offshore. On the downstream side, Cambodia is a net importer of petroleum products. We have no refinery infrastructure at this point. Most of our petroleum products are coming from Singapore, Thailand, and Vietnam. Since 2001, the royal government of Cambodia actually came out with a regulation that requires all major importers of petroleum products to have at least 30 days of their daily sale in volume stock and store properly in case of an energy situation does occur. This is our view of the power sector, that you see that the increasing the capacity until now 1,569 megawatt. This is coming from mostly from hydropower. Is because we have good potential of hydropower in Cambodia, about 10,000 megawatt, and comparing to the development is about 13% only. This energy fuel making that we have power from hydro, coal, fuel oil, biomass, and import. For the reason of the hydro development in the during the rainy season, that we have a full capacity and a full supply to the demand side. I mean that for rainy season, we don't need to import power from neighboring country. Right now, we import from Thailand, Vietnam, and Laos. In the case of dry season, we choose coal power plant for to supply in the dry season. That we have coal is mostly import from Indonesia. And we have a coal deposit also, but now under exploration. This customer and energy consumption, you can see that from year 2012 and until to 2015, the different percentage of energy sale by customer type in from year 2012 and 2015. Sector to participate and promote market enable through various incentives. And empower to the poor, involvement in rural education. As you know that renewable from developed from solar, that in our country we don't have a big scale yet, but solar home system is also promoted in the remote area. And wind energy we can find in the mountain district and coastal region, but not developed yet, because that is look very closely comparing to the hydropower development. Biomass also promote in remote area, that by using rice husk or wood chip. Biogas also promote by NGO, that in some remote area. Also by Yoshu, that Satropa is also in the plug in. You know, this the solar not only use solar home system, but we get support from NATO, from Koika for solar battery charging. This the progress of solar is the development of renewable project, but now under the study that the government gave some permission for the study more than 10 company under the study for solar power plant. It's talking about power demand and forecast from national grid. Can you say that by Japan consultant, they revised the master plan, but so by this, we have a low K, base K and high K for the development of the power. Energy mix, this we focus from, you can see that we still refer to the import from neighboring countries, but indicate that we preserve that reserve margin, power reserve margin about 25%. Before 2014, no reserve margin yet. But from now, in the master plan, we reserve for security. This transmission and distribution plan in the country that we focus until 2020, that in the whole country we have fully national grid. And this the situation that import from neighboring country, from Vietnam, is we low voltage and medium voltage and high voltage. Thailand also that with 22 kV medium voltage and high voltage. Now only medium voltage import cross-border connection. This we can show the point that we import from the country. Inform you that in Asian country, talking about hydropower, a small scale or large scale is considered is the renewable energy. So Cambodia flow from hydropower is about 33% flow in the supply side. Okay, thank you very much for your time. Attention.